Baby. on TV? That's what I wanna be. Man, it started with your practice. We'll be right back.
Okay.
This episode of Behind the Kit is brought to you by GoDPS Music Live. GoDPS Music is currently doing their huge Memorial Day sale. And from now through the end of Memorial Day, if you use coupon code MD50, you can get 50% off anything on their website. There's music instruments there, there's gear for musicians, there's accessories for musicians, and honestly, there is way more than that on the website. Again, that's coupon code MD50 for 50% off anything on GoDPSMusic.com. That link is in the description below this video, and it's from now through the end of Memorial Day. All right, let's get back to the show.
Got the dirty work out of the business. All right. Hello, everybody. Thanks for joining me Tuesday. Rocking on the drums Tuesday before Memorial Day. I took some bottom end off the drums and the track. Because last week I heard it peaking a little bit, so I had to adjust it. Believe it or not, this takes a long time to get this thing set up. I start about noontime and get the drums together, tune them a bit. I change the head on the front. I had enough of that damn skull. Now we're back to sawtooth, which is why we're here, sawtooth drums. These are the hickory drums, six plies of pure hickory. No fillers, no junk in there, no preservatives. Six plies of pure hickory.
Fan, there we go.
And die cast hoops, solid steel lugs. These drums kick butt, and there's a big sale for Memorial Day, 50% off. I think it's everything. So if you're looking for not only drum gear, you're looking for other gear, bass, guitar, whatever you need, and check it out. I think there's a link on the side. Out of there. And so the sawtooth drums, these are the hickory drums. They also have Command Series, which are cheaper, and they sound great too. Those are fantastic. It's made from poplar wood. Poplar wood, I remember years ago, I used to have sticks from Ludwig made from poplar. So I don't even smoke, but I wake up coughing. So I don't smoke anything. Years ago, it was different. And so check out the drums, check out the sale. It's really fantastic. This is, I'm still working on the one tom. I love the one tom. It's kind of like John Bonham's song. So, what did I want to mention? I know. I did a couple of interviews this week, and it's always interesting. Sometimes, you know, they book two or three during the day, and the record company, or they come up. I get a lot of email requests, and I'll look at them and usually do them, you know, schedule a day. But it usually winds up where I schedule them, and then that day I wanted to do something, or I had to go somewhere, and gosh, you know, these things are always in the way. So, but then once I do them, some of the people are really cool. And this guy, he was in somewhere in Europe, and he told me his story. He was very good friends with Jeff Nichols, who was the keyboard player in Sabbath during the Heaven and Hell album. As far as I know, the Heaven and Hell album, Mob Rules album, and the Live Evil. I don't know if he was on. I don't think he was there for the Humanizer. So he was good friends with Tony. They hung out together a lot. They were mates. And he was talking. Jeff apparently was there when I came down to audition for Sabbath. And the audition, this was 1980, right? I think it was in the summer, in August, because they were scheduled to go to Hawaii to play Aloha Stadium. I could do what they do on TV. They were scheduled to go to Hawaii and play Aloha Stadium, and we'll be right back from these messages from Sawtooth Drums. This is the Hickory Kit. Sound great? I love these drums. Anyway, so he told me they had a couple of drummers come down, and then I came down, and the reason I stuck out from the rest was because I played Neon Nights correctly. And it's funny, I did this, you know, where it goes, da 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 da. That thing on the snare. Which is a great part, Bill Ward's part. And that was a fantastic part. You could easily, any drummer, just play it. Da-da-da-da-da. Straight. Da-da-da-da-da. This added personality to it. And that, he told me that's why they liked me. I went, really? I mean, they liked the rest of it, too. But the funny thing is, I didn't know that song. I heard that song about a week before on the radio, driving on the 405 freeway. They named it 405 because it takes 4 or 5 hours to go anywhere in California, in L.A. So I'm on, and then Neon Nights comes on. I go, oh, man. That sounds good. That's the new Sabbath with that new singer, Ronnie James Dio. Because I wasn't a follower or a fan that much of Ronnie and Sabbath. I liked it. I heard Rainbow and all that, so I liked that too. But I wasn't a fan. The only fan, I was really a fan of Led Zeppelin and some of the stuff my brother did. And so I heard that on the radio, and I went, oh, cool. So I heard the parts, and I knew it did that. So, okay. And I didn't know I was getting called up to go to an audition, like, next week. So I listened to it, and then there was a break right before the guitar solo. Whatever it was. And then it went to the guitar solo. And there was no other stop in it. So when I went down to audition, they said, what do you want to play? I brought my little teeny drums with me, which Iommi was laughing at because they were so small, because they were concert toms. So that made them even smaller. There was a what size was that? 12 and a 13 and a 15 and a 16. Concert toms, bass drum, no head on the front, made the bass drum even smaller, and it was a 24. And I had this setup. I've always played with these basic cymbals. Two crashes, hi-hat, and ride. And that's why Tony, after we played some songs, he said, can you play double bass? He wanted to fill up the kit, you know, make it bigger. So I don't play double bass. So I said, you know what, Tone? I'll call the drum company. It was Ludwig at the time. And I got what's called aerial toms, which are floor toms put this way, horizontal, so I can hit them like this. So I ordered that. I ordered two of those, and then I ordered another tom in the front. That was three, and another floor tom by the hi-hat. So it made the kit bigger. And that looked better because Tony was using four stacks. Geezer was using four stacks. And Ronnie was using a very big PA with monitor system. And so that's what happened with that. And I don't know what the hell else I was going to talk about. So anyway, that was the time I went down to audition. So they asked me what song I was going to play. I thought, oh, that Neon Nights is easy, you know. I didn't know the old Sabbath stuff very well. I've heard it, and I thought it was scary back in the day. So I said, let's play Neon Nights. It's like, all right, you count it off. One, two, three, four. And when the song starts, there's no double snare in it. You know, when it goes. As soon as the guitar changes, that's where the double snare comes in. And it goes in throughout, but you don't want to overdo it. Thing with these kind of things, you play them too much. And you don't change it sometimes, even if you leave one out later on in the song. Like, do something like that. It changes it up a bit, you know? It's not so stiff. I learned the part. I got the part down. I'm going to do it until the end. See? And that goes with any kind of lick. It's nice to change it up a little bit. Let's see. The lick and then change it up a bit. I put in. So it's a good train of thought to play musical. That's playing musical. And so that was a shocking story for me, you know. And what else? So eventually I got a bigger drum set. And then eventually I got the biggest drum set there was at the time, almost, besides, I think, Terry Bozzio. Maybe Nico McBrain, I'm not sure what he had at that time, but it had 21 pieces in 2009, most of them up in the air. And after that tour, I had to go get shoulder surgery. And we have Lala in the house.
Hello.
Lala's got a lot of hellos on the side thing there, people writing in.
I do.
She's getting to be famous.
I think I am.
Yeah, you're going to have your own stream. Lala's stream. They're still waiting for your solo. And so I was talking about, you know, changing up a little bit. You could do it with beats too, you know. I did it in all the songs I just played. And by the way, that last song was on the Apice of Peace Brothers APPIC album called Sinister. And it's Carmine wrote the lyrics. It's about me growing up. Brothers in Drums, it's called. And that last song, you know, I never thought I heard him say, hey, Carmine, I don't want to be on TV like you. And all that stuff. So it's a cute song. It was a song I have a friend in Poland, Igor, a great guitar player, and we had put that down. I think Phil Susson's playing bass on that. And then Carmine wrote lyrics, and we got a singer to do it, and it's called Brothers in Drums. It's the story of me growing up with it being influenced by Carmine and driving my mother crazy like he did, you know, because we both, you know, he's 11 years older than I am, so my parents had to go through all that not noise, but banging in the bassroom, in the basement. And then I came along louder. I came along. Did that. So that's what that song was. But again, I played the beats in these three songs I just played. Take that beat. Then I change it up a little bit. See? good to change it up. Rather than staying here all the time, it's boring. So you could change the beats up too, and as long as you get back on time, you know, and you listen to Bonham and Mitch Mitchell and drummers like that playing rock, they did that, you know, and it makes it interesting, because otherwise you're just playing on top of the song. That's what I call it. You know, when you start messing with it, I like to mess with it. It becomes part of the song. It kicks it in the butt. Can I say butt?
Yes.
Lala, can I say butt?
Yes, you can.
Okay. So anyway, those are the tips of the day. And then we got what's coming up. On next Tuesday, I'll be in Vegas. I won't be here. And I'll be doing a tribute to Ronnie. And they put it together in Vegas at the Copa Room. There's an ad for it on here. It gives you the place and all that. And they're going way back to when Ronnie started with the 50s band. I think they're going to have some bands that play that stuff from the 50s and work their way up. And then I'm going to get up and play four songs like this. No, I'm not going to play that. And of course, you got to play this stuff steady. Put that metronome on. Okay, let's take some questions. And I thank everybody for watching, coming back every week. It's starting to be like a hangout, you know, in that room, which is a sidebar. I think if I could, I would serve some margaritas and chips.
Ooh,
and salsa.
Let's just do that here.
Yeah,
cheaper.
For everybody. Probably like that. And then I would sound better, you know, a couple of margaritas. Okay, so let's take some questions.
Also, the code for the 50% off.
What is?
There's a code for the 50% off. It's good through Memorial Day.
Yeah, that's what I was saying before. MD50. We have that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, make sure that's up there.
What's the code?
MD50.
MD50, yeah. Okay, so you put that in. You go to the website at the end of the checkout, I believe. They'll take 50% off. That's a lot. You know, if you're looking for any of this stuff, that is really good deal. So I would check that out. And, I mean, you know, if you want a good, really great set of drums that sound like this, this is what you want. Because if you get some other brand, see, Chromacast and Sawtooth and this whole company is rocked out. Joe Fuoco is a drummer, and a lot of the guys that work in that, not a store, company, they're musicians, and they're very proactive with promoting and video. That's why I'm here every week, you know. There's no other company like this, and they make some great stuff. They make guitars, they make basses, they make cajones, they make, what else they make? They make everything. They make so much stuff. It's incredible. And Joe's hands-on. He's a great drummer. He plays at the Viper Room a lot with Michael Badio. He's with the company. Rudy's with the company. Rudy Saza, myself, Mike Hansen from Hurricane. So you got to check these drums out, you know, and if you're looking for a killer set. Because if you get the wrong set, you know, what happens is you wind up playing like this. That you check out this set, Sawtooth, even the Command Series, which is the lower end kit, you got. Okay. So check it out, 50% off. Get it while it's hot. And this is, I guess, through Memorial Day. Now let's take some questions. I think we got some good questions.
We got some good questions, I think so.
And this goes out to my friend Alan Cornett, who is recovering from a really crappy accident he had in his house, and he's left him in a bad state, but he's getting better all the time, as the Beatles say. So send my prayers and my wishes to Alan. So he's a good guy. Good drummer, too. Okay.
When recording in the studio, how do you accomplish a nice open snare tunings when the engineer always wants to muffle or dampen it?
You got to fight back. I'm telling you, this muffling stuff's out of hand. This stuff is like making you wear a mask outside, you know, with this COVID stuff going on. Because what happens is these guys get used to their own way of doing things. And with Last in Line, we don't carry our own sound man. So when we go play, right away, I'll tune up, get my drums, so, and they put the mics on, and they'll look at my bass drum, this bass drum here. What a nice tone. There's only a little face cloth in it, which is for the microphone to sit on. So it doesn't sound like a bunch of pillows and all that. And then they'll put Gates on the drums. It's like, wait a minute. Listen to the effing drums first. Any good sound guy, engineer, should listen to the drummer, listen to his drums, and then get the best out of that. Not the other way around. Not, oh, I'm going to tape it up. I'm going to tape this up. I'm going to make the snare drum sound like this. That's ridiculous. So you got to put your foot down. Right? No pun intended. I mean, I record like this. Listen to that snare. There's a little bit of reverb on here, but that snare drum is just tuned lug to lug. The snares are loose. I don't like the tight snares. I this is what I like. And when you got this, you got attack, you know. Then what you do is you put your foot down and say, I don't want that crap on my drums. I want the snare to sing. If you don't like it this wide open, then you can tape it a little bit and see what you got. Then go in and listen to it. If there's a bit too much ring, you can try to tune things out. It's always best to try to tune any rings or annoying overtones with the key before you start muffling it. So join the anti-muffling club. Vinny's anti-muffling club. Okay, next question.
Where can you buy Vinny's drumsticks?
You could buy these online at Sawtooth. But I don't know if they have my name on them. I've lost track of all that. These are just Chromacast 5Bs. Chromacast is the same company, basically. 5B turned this way. The man's way. As I always say, this side here is for girls. Nah, I'm kidding. But I play this way. It's not for girls. There's some killer drummers out there, and they play killer drummers that all genders play that way. But I've always played this way. I don't know why. But there's a lot more sound coming out with the wood, like, you know, hitting snares like this. So check them out on sawtoothworld.com. I thought they used to have them at Walmart, too. Okay, next question.
What is your funniest or favorite memory of Jimmy Bain?
All of it. Jimmy Bain. Jimmy Bain was the bass player in Dio, and he was also the bass player with Ronnie in Rainbow as well. That's how the connection took place with when we formed Dio. Jimmy was an easy choice, you know. Jimmy liked to party. He liked women on the road. He was a rock and roll animal, road warrior, the whole bit. And one of the funny things I always remember is We were in some hotel somewhere. I think it was a night off. We're going, let's go get something to eat. So a bunch of us, we're going to meet downstairs. So we met, actually, we on the fifth or sixth floor. And we went to get the elevator, and there's a couch there, and Jimmy's asleep. There's a chair, and Jimmy's asleep on the chair. And we said, let's put Jimmy in the elevator. So we all carried the chair in the elevator. He didn't wake up. And we put him in there, and he went up and down probably all night. And actually, I'm reading a Led Zeppelin book, and I finished it. And it's quite interesting. So they did the same thing to some, I don't know if they did it to Bonzo or Keith Moon or whatever. They did the same thing, you know. And one time, another funny story was, I know this was Buffalo, New York. It was the Hyatt House. And we were on tour with Motorhead and Judas Priest. And we were all in the bar, and there's a see-through elevator, glass, and it's where the airline industry stayed. And Phil Campbell, the guitar player, he's a funny guy, had a fart machine, but it was remote controlled. And of course we were having a laugh with that, but then he got in the elevator with all these pilots and stewardesses, and he had the speaker on him, and we had the remote. So he'd go up in the elevator, and then and he'd make the move and all that, and he could see the people moving away from him. It was great. That went on for a while. You'd think we'd grow up, but no.
No.
I mean, who else can do this stuff? You know, this is a good job when you can get it. All right, next question.
What drum mics are you using here in the studio?
Drum mics, this is a Shure 56. What is this called? 57. Oh man, I'm losing it. That's a Shure 57. These are Shure Tom. I don't know what this. Sick. I can't tell what those mics are because I can't see them. Hey, Lala, there's a flashlight right next to you. She's so good. Look at that.
Try not to pull any wires or knock cameras over.
It's called a Shure PGA 56. So we got those on the toms. And then I got two Samson overhead mics, and these are condenser mics, one there. And in the bass drum is a Shure 91, which is a flat mic. And there's a subwoofer mic made by some company. I don't know the name of it, but that is a subwoofer, and what it is, it's like an 8-inch, that one's 6-inch speaker in an enclosure wired as a mic, and that gets the low end. Nice low end on it, and it's great to record because the 91 mic inside the drum's getting a lot of the attack, and that subwoofer's getting a lot of the bottom end, so you got a nice mix. And that's about it. The hi-hat, there's no mic on the hi-hat, but there is another one, which is a Samson condenser, little mic that I have over there when I record. But these are the same mics, and these are really good mics. They're not really expensive mics, but they do the trick. You know, these Shure mics, these are about $100 each. So it's great. And then I got two room mics, AKG, one there and one there, and those are pencil mics, really thin. And those are room mics. They're not connected to this system. You're not hearing those mics. But when I record, I put them in the mix. You know, I put the mics away, far away from me, so you can get an ambience sound from them. Very good. Good question. Okay, let's take a couple more.
How do you get the board feed to the computer and then to Facebook?
Ha, 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 ha. It took me a while to figure out how to get a decent sound with Facebook audio. So a because I got a 16 input DAW, they call them, you know. So I got 16 inputs and echoes to Cubase on the computer. And there it's different. You got all the channels, you got all the drums on separate channels. So when I went to the output of that into the computer via USB, because this is a Focusrite system with 16 inputs, and the output is a USB into the computer, and then the software makes it work. So when I did that, the drums were all over the place. I heard a bass drum on the left. I heard a snare on the right. Toms were in the distance. So I go, what is going on with this? So I had to sit there. It took a couple of weeks to figure out what's going on. What you got to do is everything's got to go through a mixer. I got two 8-channel mixers, so 16 inputs. Everything goes through there. And then there's one final stereo output with left and right, two cables. That goes to the Focusrite inputs, 1 and 2. So you got a mixer. All the mics are plugged into the mixer. You come out of the mixer, left and right, and it goes into the audio card. Well, my audio card is Focusrite, and you go 1 and 2. And that will feed into, that's what feeds into Facebook. Then you got to test it. You got to make sure it's not peaking. You got to check the levels and you know, see what kind of sound you're getting. So actually, I got all these mics. I don't know, there might be 8, 10 mics going through into the input 1 and 2 of the audio interface, and that USBs goes into the computer. And then I put a little EQ. This got a little, you could hear the reverb. Okay. There's a little bit of burb, not on this. That's dry. That's dry. And then I pan them. See, this is panned in the middle. This is over to the left. Over to the left more. And that's what I do. And it works. Took a while. Okay, let's take one more question. That was just off the top of my head, but it's melodic. It's going. Took that little rhythm, brought it into two different kind of parts, and played a beat to it. It could be a song around that, you know. But that's playing melodic. Repeat. You repeat the rhythms, and then go to a different part. All right, one more question.
Will Last in Line be on the 2024 Monsters of Rock cruise? Do you know?
I don't know. When is that? February?
I don't know. I think that's February, March or something. I'm not sure.
Well, you know what? I think we're on something, right?
Yeah, but I don't know if it's that one. Yeah, there might be one.
I think we're on another cruise.
A rock and roll one.
A rock and roll cruise, of course. And it's called The Gentleman of Rock.
The Gentleman of Rock.
It's The Gentleman. Hello, sir. How are you? Vivian, what should we play today? How about Rainbow in the Dark? Okay.
Oh, the cruise is in March.
It's in March?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Let me put it up there.
Give me a reminder of that.
We don't know
February.
Yet. You don't know.
So anyway, thank you guys for joining me. Don't forget the ChromaCast Sawtooth coupon. I think Sawtooth coupon, 50% off. I mean, come on. Anything you need. You need a snare drum. These snare drums are not cheap. This is the Hickory snare drum. It's a great snare drum. If you can't get this stuff, check out the Command Series line of drums. both sound great and they record great. So 50% off and until Memorial Day. All right, so you guys have a safe Memorial Day. I won't be back next Tuesday. I will be in Vegas. And we'll have a rerun, so if you miss me, you can watch that, me and Lala. And Lala, come over here and show your face here. Come on this side. Everybody forgot what you look like. Yeah. There you are. There's Lala. Hit the drum. Now, she played, now that's a very odd rhythm. That wasn't that, is. I gave her both sticks, that's what she played. So anyway, thank you guys. I really love doing this, and I love seeing you guys all online. And have a safe Memorial Day, and happy birthday to Paul. I missed his birthday this week. And anybody else that's having a birthday, awesome. Happy birthday. And I'll see you in 2 weeks, okay?